fight coming up next, a UFC featherweight division fight. He's one of the more accomplished strikers in this division. Sprawl and brawl, whatever you want to say, he's going to try to keep this fight standing tonight.
It does not matter how he accomplishes it. All he wants to do is be on his feet and at range, hitting you with the beautiful jab, staying away from the grappling exchanges. You don't accomplish all the things that this man has accomplished over the course of his career without understanding distance. He has great distance management, which then in turn allows him to land all these beautiful, diverse kicks, spinning back kick, jumping high kick, so many things he possesses that he will try to use tonight in this fight.
Yeah, if this turns into a kickboxing match tonight, most people believe, yeah, his opponent is in a world of trouble. Well, you can argue this is the most influential martial artist of all time, the great Bruce Lee, making his walk to the octagon here tonight, champ.
Everybody wants to be Bruce Lee. They say they want to be like Mike. If you're a fighter, you want it to be like Bruce Lee. You want it to be that fast. You want it to be that charismatic. You want it to have an ability to just freeze your opponents. Your speed, your movement, just the diversity in the attacks that you can give your opponents would just confuse people. I mean, I watched him beat a 7-foot Kareem Abdul-Jabbar to stay undefeated.
Right.
If you can do that, you can do anything.
I fear not the man who has practiced 10,000 kicks once, but I fear the man who has practiced one kick 10,000 times. Bruce Lee in a nutshell.
Just so wise.
Our tale of the day for this, our main event of the evening. So 2 years, the gap in age, with similar height and some differences in reach. All right, now for the particulars, we go inside the octagon.
This is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon is Herb Dean. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out Madison Square Garden Arena in New York City, it's time! 5 rounds in the UFC featherweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a kickboxer, making his professional debut here tonight. He stands 5 feet 5 inches tall, weighing in at 140 pounds. Fighting out of Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, Assassin. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a mixed martial artist making his professional debut here tonight. He stands 5 feet 7 inches tall, weighing in at 145 pounds. Fighting out of Los Angeles, California, Bruce the Dragon Lee.
You've been given your instructions in the dressing room. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. We will have a clean fight. Touch gloves. Let's make it official.
They touch him up, and we are underway.
Ready. Ready to fight?
All right, crowd getting excited as this fight gets underway, and you hate to call any fighter on this UFC roster a specialist, but on one side, you have a definite striker taking on a true five-tool player.
And you see a guy in the striker who knows exactly who he is. He knows where the fight needs to be. He knows what he has to do in order to be successful. Let's see if he can keep his opponent off of him. Big, powerful punch lands. Now he gets back in range.
And made good use of it there with that punch. Moving to his left. Pretty good knee to the body by Lee. Block that kick to the body.
Look at the whip action that comes from him throwing that kick.
Oh, how about that? He lands a huge kick.
Look at the angle of that nice body kick.
And he landed the right hand there. Just over 2 minutes to go.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one?
And he gets absolutely punished by that head kick.
When you're in a clinch, you can pull down on the head and land beautiful. Head.
Just misses with that one. Lee's kick is blocked.
That right hand landed.
Swing and a miss with that straight left hand.
Ooh, what a punch.
Just misses with the left hook.
Come on, man. Let's get that takedown. Score some points.
Look at how he turns his hip over when he throws that kick.
Straight punch there, lands on the counter. Nice job using his reach advantage there. Oh, he's had a huge strike right there. I'm not sure how many more of these his opponent can take.
Massive shot that he landed. Great job.
So strong 5 minutes down. All right, let's take a look back at some of the replays, DC, and if you like the kicking game, that was the round for you.
Yeah, man, he used his kicks beautifully. He managed distance, managed space, and eventually those kicks started to really take an effect on his opponent and slow him down. He has to stay the course next round.
All right, here we go as our next round gets underway. His strong leg packs so much power that even when he doesn't throw it full throttle, you see he's able to inflict damage. We'll see if he can keep it going here in this
round. He doesn't throw it full power, but even when he faints it, he draws out reactions from his opponents because they don't want to get hit with any more of those kicks. It's a sight to behold. Look at how he turns his hip into that leg kick.
Just unable to quite find that range.
Oh, the difference in the striking is crazy.
Oh, head kick.
I mean, it was perfect. It was absolutely perfect, John. Great placement for that uppercut.
All right, so he's landed some good shots tonight, but this is not a combo meal, right? No three-piece, no soda. It's one and done more often than not.
John, don't you come to me without a combo. I want the whole platter. Give him the whole platter, young man. Put some punches together. Make this guy take the whole thing. Give him more than one strike. You have now found a setup punch. The jab is landing consistently. Find something that's going to go behind it. Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with those leg kicks. Nice punch lands over the top. Look at the force behind that leg kick.
Head kick home, and now his opponent in a world of trouble.
Such a sneaky head kick. He did not recognize it. It was coming high, and now he's got him hurt bad.
He's been working hard defensively. Kick block there. Well, a really good second round for him thus far. After a somewhat lackluster first round, he has found the rhythm and found his striking range. Scary proposition for the opponent now here in round two. Well, he's got the kicking game going tonight. Lands another one there.
A beautiful kick, and all I can think of, better him than me.
Connects with a right hand. Pretty good punch, that one.
Nice right punch by this young man. Take a head kick like this. That is such toughness to even be on his feet right now.
big knee to the body. Really starting to connect on a lot of shots to the midsection, and these will take their toll as this fight goes into the latter rounds. And that's the end of round number two. All right, so let us now check out some of the action in that round, DC. There was a whole lot of it, including a stunner upstairs that nearly closed the show.
It was a lot of action. It was back and forth action, but the big moment was that big strike to the head that landed that put him on wobbly legs and in survival mode. Luckily, he made it to the end of that round.
You ready to fight? Ready.
Third round underway. Well, just as he did in the previous round, continuing to land a high number of strikes here, and he hasn't really showed any signs of slowing down. Scary, scary proposition for the opponent.
Nice body kick right under the elbow.
Oh, massive head kick there. We'll see if he can finish. Circling to his right.
Right at the elbow, body kick land.
Nice. Keep moving. If they take shot, now take
shot. Punch over the top.
Lee gets absolutely melted by that head kick. Oh, really using his reach advantage as he landed the jab there. Just over 3 minutes to go in round three. Well, we wondered earlier why there weren't as many body strikes. He's making up for lost time here. Shot to the body connects, and that bears watching. That's gonna hurt this opponent. Oh, it's a beautiful kick right there. I don't know if you've ever been kicked by a mule. Probably feels something like that.
It has to. This guy has landed his kick with so much force.
Able to check that kick as well. Over the top. This fight's gonna be over, DC.
What a great way of mixing up his attack. He didn't stay the course. He mixed it up. He went high when his opponent thought he was going low, and now he's got him hurt very badly.
Unable to connect there. Well, he is really starting to apply a lot of pressure here down the stretch. Not as much offense earlier in the fight. He is making up for lost time now. Big knee there.
Oh, nice right hand.
Another shot lands upstairs.
Game of inches right there. Wow. It was a good night if that landed. He has a commitment to kicking tonight, and it shows.
That's three rounds in the can. We're headed to the championship rounds. Well, what a round it was, especially from a striking standpoint. DC, take us through.
High-level striking. I mean, this is what people come through the doors to see. Two men stand on a quarter, chest to chest, forehead to forehead, and let it all fly. I'm surprised nobody went out, but it does excite me for the next round.
You ready to fight? Ready. Good.
Blocks that kick to the body. Well, not only has he stayed aggressive as he was in the previous round, landing a high volume of strikes, but he's also been efficient, not just with his strikes, but also with his body movement. Complete performance out of this fighter here tonight.
knees to the body.
And he connects with a punch there. We'll see if there's more where that came from. Significant strike attempt there, but a huge block. Oh, man, that's a nice kick right there.
He's doing a great job of landing that kick over and over again.
Nice job to land the kick to the body there by Lee. Just out of range with that strike. Hard shots landing on both sides.
That's a big strike right there.
Lands the right hand.
I mean, he's cutting down the size with these beautiful leg kicks.
While the body was wide open, his opponent took advantage. Kick to the body lands flush. He's gonna have to make some adjustments here moving forward. Lee gets absolutely tagged by that stiff jab. Nice job by the fighter here to continue to block the shots coming his way. You think he's trying to sort of fatigue his opponent here a little bit?
He's kind of watching and seeing everything that's happening in front of him. Later, you'll see him start to counter after blocking shots. Nice straight punch. Big leg kick lands.
Oh, and he lands another punch there, and you can tell at this point he is going right at that cut on his opponent.
Right at the cut on the eye, just making sure he knows that I'm going to be targeting it. Keep your hands up, and when the hands go up, he will then change the target down low, trying to find finishes.
45 seconds remain in the round. His opponent still standing.
I mean, I have no idea. This fight is supposed to be over. And it might not be over now, but it's gotta be over very soon.
Oh!
Big kick lands.
What a round. Well, I'm not sure the extent to which he has recovered, but we do see the end of the round. DC, talk us through the replay.
Well, he's a tough guy. He's going to make it to the stool. He's going to survive unless you put him completely out of there. Unfortunately, he's in there with a guy that does have that ability.
Ready to fight? Ready.
We have arrived at this fifth and final round.
Big punch land. He's throwing every part of himself into these big leg kicks.
And he caught the kick.
Look at him whip his hip into that kick. Very tricky when he throws that body kick.
Right on the button.
Nice looping punch. Big body kick lands.
Nice connection on the counter punch there, and oftentimes, DC, it can be easier to be a counter striker when you have such a pronounced edge in reach. Blocks the shot. Just over 3 minutes now to go in the fight.
Nice leg kick.
And both guys really throwing with authority. Right punches there. Punch there by Lee. Oh, a huge block there. Oh, looking to land the leg kick, but unable to find the target.
Take your face. Start all over again. Take your face.
Well, that body kick was there earlier, not there on that attempt.
Look at him drive his chin into the opponent's body with that body kick.
Time to get the bonus checks ready.
I mean, this fight is about done. He's got him hurt very bad with his head kick. Now he has to find one more strike to end the night.
Oh!
He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Single collar tie there. All right, boy, Ty clinch. A lot of elbows and knees could be coming from here. We'll see how he chooses to attack.
Yeah, it's a very dangerous position, but an advantageous one for the offensive fighter. Watch for the defensive guy to try to break this immediately. Big kick land.
Beautiful straight punch there. His boxing fundamentals are just so clean.
Oh, he looks so sharp tonight.
What a fight! Official decision now in.
After five rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. Judge 1 scores this contest 48-47, Assassin. Judge 2 scores it 48-47, Lee. And Judge 3 scores it 48-47 for the winner by split decision, Bruce the Dragon Lee.
Wow, so there he is, your winner by the narrowest of margins. Only 3 scorecards in the world matter. 2 of them thought he won.
I mean, you could tell that he wasn't sure he had got enough done to win the fight. He gets the decision. It was a very close fight, and it's well earned. I'm still winning.